Hello and welcome. A few days ago, a user made a comment on one of my videos that Asrock B650i ITX motherboard apparently has an option to turn the GPU slot to PCIe Gen 5. I was skeptical, but there was no harm in checking it out. Lo and behold, indeed it does have an option to turn its GPU slot to Gen 5. Spec-wise, it is supposed to be only PCIe Gen 4, so what's going on here? Is it a bug? Since I have Asrock A620i as well, I figured I'd look into its BIOS as well, which is what you are looking at right now. The BIOS version is 3.25, which is the latest version released on May 22nd. You can also see the CPU I am using. Now, if you look under Advanced, you can see AMD PBS. Under that, you can see AMD Common Platform Module. Under that, you can see PCIe by 16 link speed. And you can see that I can choose generation 1 to 5. The text makes it clear that this is about the GPU slot. The big question is whether it actually works the way it is labeled. Just because BIOS says it does, it doesn't always mean it is actually applied in reality. I learned that from working with Chinese motherboards. Anyway, I've selected Generation 5. Now, I am going into Windows 11. You are looking at GPU-Z and CPU-Z. The former is showing PCIe Gen 4 for my NVIDIA 4060, which is correct. The latter is also showing GPU interface as Gen 4 and 8 lanes. Both are correctly detecting because NVIDIA 4060 does not support Gen 5. So, how can I test that, whether this motherboard can support Gen 5? I don't have NVIDIA 5000 series GPU, so I am going back to BIOS and choose Gen 3 and see how these two applications respond. Very interesting. GPU-Z is reporting correctly PCIe as the third gen. However, CPU-Z is still reporting it as Gen 4. Therefore, I think I can conclude that CPU-Z cannot be trusted for this at this point. Or it could be that CPU-Z is reporting highest allowed. Or it could simply be reading from its database instead of actually detecting things. Either way, how would I test further? Well, I've decided to take the GPU out and use HWinfo. All right, I've taken out the GPU and set PCIe Gen to 5. Now let's look at what the application says. At this point, I am inclined to believe that the option for Gen 5 exists, because the BIOS programmers didn't want to differentiate between many different BIOS versions. And A620 chipset cannot support Gen 5 technically anyway. Just because BIOS has an option for it, it doesn't mean it supports it. Still, I'd like further evidence, so I am going to do the same thing with a B650 motherboard. This is Asrock B650M Pro RS, a mid-range AM5 motherboard. B650 chipset can technically support PCIe Gen 5, although it's only for M.2 slots. As you can see, the BIOS here is updated to the latest as well, and I am going to set the PCIe option to Generation 5. Nothing I see here suggests that the main GPU slot is Generation 5. However, before this bit, I did try booting with generation 3 selected, and it didn't reflect in this application either. Therefore, hrinfo seems to be reading it from database instead of actually reading the hardware. The same applies to CPU-Z as well. In the end, it looks like only GPU-Z is reliable, and I don't have NVIDIA 5000 series GPU. I could certainly purchase it and test this out, but as a casual gamer, I generally never purchase a new GPU at full price. If GPU was cheaper, I would have tempted to buy it just to see where it goes, but even GIMPed NVIDIA 5060 costs half a grand in Canada. So, the result is inconclusive, unfortunately. My gut feeling here is that, as said earlier, Asrock BIOS programmers added Gen 5 option to everything, because they were either lazy or couldn't care less. If hardware itself cannot support it, it won't work anyway, was probably their line of thoughts. I don't think Gen 5 will work on a 620 chipset natively. Still, I feel there is a chance that Gen 5 may just work on B650 motherboards. Like I said a moment ago, the result was inconclusive. What I did confirm was that the option does change active PCIe Gen on the GPU slot. I was about to end this video here, but I realized that there was a cheaper way to test this out by using PCIe Gen 5 NVMe adapter and a Gen 5 M.2 drive. This method still cost me nearly 200 Canadian rubles, but it is better than spending nearly $600. Here we are. A day later, these two items arrived from Amazon. One is PCIe Gen 5 adapter, and the other is Gen 5 M.2 SSD. This should allow me to test what version a physical PCI Express slot is running at. It is in and properly powered up. But just to see whether this works, I am going to choose Generation 2 and see what Crystal Disk Info software reports. So far, so good. The software is properly reporting that the SSD is running at Gen 2 speed. Now, I am going to select Generation 5 in BIOS and see what it reports. At last, I am going to confirm this. Just as I feared, nope. The BIOS option is meaningless because the hardware cannot physically support Generation 5. It is running at Generation 4 speed, which is the highest it can go. Although it's going to be meaningless, I am going to try the same thing with A620 chipset motherboard. This is on B650 chipset, by the way. If B650 can't support it, there is absolutely no way that A620 chipset can support Gen 5. So, in the end, it doesn't work on A620 chipset either. This is expected. Then why is the option even there to begin with? Well, I did explain earlier. The BIOS programmers probably didn't differentiate all different motherboards and decided to use the same template for everything. If physical hardware cannot support it, it won't work anyway. Given how many different motherboards Asrock has, I suppose I could understand their point of view. But then, everyone seems to be cutting corners nowadays, in spite of rapid price increases in recent years. The prices of motherboards have shot up a lot with the introduction of DDR5. It took a few years for AM5 motherboards to come down in price. Even then, baseline price seems to be a few tens of bucks higher. It's even worse for ITX motherboards because it costs around 300 Canadian rubles for a mid-range motherboard. Gone are the days where CPU was much more expensive than a motherboard. Nowadays, every single component is expensive. And I don't even want to talk about GPU prices. The lowest end card, which is Nvidia 5060, will cost me around 430 Canadian rubles. But that is the cheapest model with one fan. If I want anything slightly better, then the price goes up to 499. With tax and all, I am looking at 550. Do you know what's worse? If I want more than 8 GB of VRAM, I will need to spend around $700. I am forced to wait until the end of year for a discount. Well, enough grumbling. Thank you for watching and see you next time.